Hello all, this is YouTube video update for June 18th, 2016 for politics. I checked with a few friends about the radio show for this, and it looks like I have more of a chance on doing it with my friend Jerry from church than I am with my other friend Nelson. Nelson really doesn't want to. He's got other things on his mind. He's trying to get things in life together, so I totally respect that. But we will still be joking through email. So the actual radio show version of this won't be done until Jerry wants to. So. But in any case, this past week in politics has been stupid as usual. Things are getting really, really, really ridiculous. I mean, it's getting to the point where I don't know what the hell to say. The liberal judge I spoke about last time is trying to get Donald Trump for being a racist. Everyone is claiming that Donald Trump is against all Muslims. He specifically said that I'm banning all Muslim Islamic fanatics. He never said banning Muslims in general. But of course, the liberal media like Fox News, CNN, and MSNBC, and all the other news channels are claiming that he's a total racist. Now they're just totally trying to discredit him on anything he's saying. He can say the sky's blue and they'll claim that he's saying that the sky is getting ready to cloud up. The whole thing is just plain, it really is getting stupid. Hillary is doing her typical routine. She's now got this commercial where she's saying that she likes kids, she wants to work with them, she's all for education, and yet at the same time, she hates kids. She doesn't want them. Meantime, she's got Chelsea there. Yeah, Chelsea, $10,000 a month for her apartment rental thing. And then all three of them consider themselves broke at $50 million. Now, which I'm really surprised that they're not attacking Hillary for, is that she's got $400 million from the Clinton Foundation, and the FBI and IRS are not auditing her. I find that highly coincidental. Okay? Everyone is against her, but yet they won't indict her. What does that tell you? It is really beginning to be days of our lives. Cruz is now endorsing Hillary, because everyone is all the liberals are thinking that Hillary is totally qualified, when she really isn't. Now you got that idiot, that liberal idiot, Oprah Winfrey, who's now endorsing Hillary, because now she's saying, the U.S., it's about time that the U.S. is having a woman president. This goes to show you the whole mentality of it is. On Waters World, if you've ever seen Bill O'Reilly on the O'Reilly Factor, he has this Waters World segment. He had a black woman that he interviewed. And she said, yes, I have nothing against a woman being a U.S. president, but Hillary is not qualified. Now, that's a black woman saying that. Okay, not a liberal black. A regular black woman. Now, whether she changes her mind later on is a horse of a different color. There are too many liberals for Hillary. So now she's got a notch in her, which gives her a better chance of becoming president. It isn't the fact that you have the right to vote. It isn't that. It's the liberals who want her there. The context of the government claiming that you have a right to vote is diminished. There is no point in voting. All it is a bunch of liberals who are putting a politician in office for the sake of getting what the politician promises them. But it also depends on which politician promises who. Okay? Bernie Sanders. We all love Bernie Sanders because he's the one that wants everyone to have what's coming to them, and he wants everyone to get what they need. He wants everyone to give every single college student a free education. He's saying that the government is going to pay for it. Meantime, where does the government get the money? The taxpayer. So, everyone is paying, like I tell my friend Liz and Jerry and my mother when we talk on Saturdays. I refuse to give a college student a free education, and I refuse to pay taxes on that free education when all these kids do nothing but go to a dorm room, gangbang Monday, drink until you piss ass drunk Tuesday, oral sex Wednesday, orgy Thursday, cramming in on Friday, ace the test on Saturday, and act smart. Key word, acting. They act smart on Sunday so they can make themselves look like they're educated. Meantime, if you ask any one of the college students, where's Colorado?
Oh, yeah, I don't know. Isn't that next to Nevada?
You're in it, you idiot. And half of them who are outside of Colorado couldn't even tell you because they don't even know, they don't know a damn thing about their geography. Okay? Yes, I've always said it, and I'll say it again. I'm anti-American. Not a terrestrial one, but I'm anti-American. And I even know where Colorado is. Okay? Now, I also even know where Ohio is. I also know where Illinois is. Illinois is right next to the left of the south. It's right next to Georgia. No. Fuck me. Not an instruction, of course. That's not near... That's Mississippi. Brain dead moment. hey, excuse me, but for those of you liberals out there who are ready, getting ready to scrutinize me for that, at least I'm not thinking that there's 57 states, okay? Illinois is right under Ohio, or right next to it, okay? It's right next to Virginia. And that's not even looking at Google right now. Otherwise, you'd hear clicking going on. the whole college thing, I just refuse to pay taxes for college kids. I refuse to do it. If you're going to go to college to pick up, to get a degree on something, if you're going to become a welder, a registered nurse, by all means, go for it. You get a government grant for that. Okay, you take out a loan, a student loan, as a matter of fact. Fine, you pay it back later on when you get yourself some employment. That's nothing. I have nothing against that. But don't sit there and tell me, well, the government's going to pay for it. Meantime, they don't tell you the government is getting the money from the taxpayer. Every single dollar that the government gets is through the taxpayer, besides their printing machines. Now, for those of you who haven't had this analyzed yet, this debt crisis, I honestly don't think it exists. I don't think that the government is in $19.5 trillion in debt, okay? I don't think so. They blame it on China. China is too educated to give the U.S. money to borrow when they know damn well that the U.S. won't pay them back. Okay, that's common sense. Because they haven't paid them back since the Bush era. So, I highly doubt that the Chinese are that stupid. With all the printing presses that they have to make money, the new bills, where do you think the bank gets their new bills from? They get it from printing presses. So to say that the country is in debt, no, they just take more money, they print it out, and they waste it. The only reason why they say, well, we're in debt and we got to grow the economy is because they're letting the illegals in and they're giving the money to everyone else except their own, which is why they're losing so much money besides the politicians wasting it. Obama flies out in his Air Force One jet. Well, it's not, technically it's not a jet, but it's an Air Force One airplane, okay? It's an Air Force One plane. That thing must cost... it does cost $400 million an hour. Because you got to pay for staff, you got to pay for the food, you got to pay for the gas, which isn't cheap. I mean, geez, you take Air Force One and put it on alongside a regular plane, damn, I can fly up to New York when I'm visiting my mother in the South and pay $500. Now, $500... 580, something like that. 580, rounding, yeah, 580, 550, 580. Round, now times that by, say, 300 people. Okay? That's $3 million. Now, that $3 million can only cost, let's say, probably cost $3,000 for the fuel. And maybe $1.5 million for the staff. You can't tell me that all that money goes for them. But anyways, before we get sidetracked, that's minuscule compared to Air Force One. Air Force One, you're paying overly paid people. So you're wasting money on Air Force One compared to the regular planes. But they are so wasteful. The government is so wasteful with its money that the government will always be in debt. I mean, it's going to get to the point where they're not going to be able to get themselves out of debt. By the time Hillary gets out of office, it's going to be about $23 trillion. I guarantee you, it's going to be about $23 trillion by the time Hillary gets out of office. And then the next Hitler that goes in office after her is going to rack up another $1 trillion debt, which is probably going to be 25. So, the economy is shot. The economy is done. China has 10 times the economy because they know what the hell they're doing. The U.S. doesn't. The U.S. is so stupid that it's getting to the point where the U.S. can't be, the U.S. cannot be saved in general because there's too many stupid people in it. You got the liberal, you got 3/4 of the country that's made up of liberals. All the liberals don't think straight. The liberals only want what they want. And the innocent victims are made to suffer. Now, you take someone like me, I refuse to vote, I don't take part in voting. I don't vote. Now, many of you may say, well, you have to vote. No, you don't. Simply because it is your choice to, whether you want to or don't want to take part in the corruption. I refuse to take part in the corruption. So I can honestly say with full enthusiasm that I've had absolutely no part in the corruption since Reagan. So I can complain because I haven't been part of the corruption. And many of you, or some of you may say, well, I can complain and you can complain because of the things that are going on. We're not getting what we need. Yeah, okay. Yeah, we have a right to complain, Of course we all have a right to complain when it comes to corruption. But I know by common sense that it won't do anything unless something catastrophic happens. That's the only way you'll be able to fix something. So, it's really stupid. And then you get these stupid senators and these stupid judges who think all things are racist. So now the judges, like the one that's doing with Donald Trump, he doesn't want Donald Trump in office because he's claiming that he's racist, all because he misinterpreted and reinterpreted what Donald Trump said. So now everyone is trying to destroy Donald Trump because the courtroom judge, the liberal judge, is racist himself. He will only give if you don't know, the courtroom judge is of Latin descent. He's a Mexican. Now, go figure. The majority of the illegals that are coming into the country are Mexican. So now, why do you think all the illegal Mexicans are coming into the country and getting what they want? Because of the liberals and the liberal politicians and the liberal judges. So, you know why things are so fucked up, in the literal term of it. Liberals don't think right. If you really want to know, for those of you who really have not watched a liberal in action, watch The Five and watch Bill O'Reilly. They're on the O'Reilly Factor. They have Juan Williams, and they have Juan Williams is the only liberal on The Five besides what's her name? Another Democrat. I forget what her name is, but she usually sits all the way on the right on The Five, outnumbered. Okay. You also get a couple of liberals on the O'Reilly Factor. Those liberals want the communists in office because the communists will give them what they want, which is why the innocent victims in this country can't get what they need, because the liberals are always getting what they want. Even the blacks. The blacks will always defend the blacks because they are liberals themselves. Now, yes, there are some good blacks out there, but the only ones you hear about are the liberal blacks who are probably also on welfare, who just want what they want when they want, and they will pull a politician in office to get what they want, even if the politician is a Hitler. That's why your insurance in this country is done. That's why retirement is done. That's why medical insurance is done. There's a Japanese physicist. If you don't know, it's Michio Kaku. He does regular YouTube videos on here. And he said, in the year 2020, there's not going to be any more health insurance. Which I can totally agree with, mainly because when you look at the health insurance you have these days, they rob you. Got a $3,000 surgery, and the insurance company will only pay $200 of it, maybe $300 at the most. They're cons. They're also crucifying Donald Trump because of the border thing. He wants to ban all Islamic fanatical Muslims. Good. I'd ban them too. I'd ban all of them. But the thing that ticks me off is that they go on these planes and they don't get strip searched. I go and I pay $500 and I get searched. They don't. So, the whole thing is just plain stupid. Oh, if you also notice that this zoo thing, they haven't talked about that in a week. Oh, and this cute thing about this kid who imitated Sanders, Hillary, and Donald Trump. That was cute. I have to honestly say that was cute. But yeah, the politics this week has been totally boring. They should stop attacking Donald Trump and start crucifying Hillary. Okay? That's the whole thing. This is the end of the YouTube video update for politics on June 18, 2016. We're going to go on to antisocial media.